Let us now talk about units in more detail. Here we'll talk about the definition as well as some characteristics we specify for a unit. So first, if we talk about what is a unit, like in previous slide we already discussed, here we can say all physical quantities are measured with respect to a standard magnitude of same physical quantity. And if we talk about the standard magnitude of same physical quantity, we can also add which has a constant magnitude. Remember that the standard magnitude we are talking will remain constant. These are called the standard magnitude or constant magnitude of the physical quantity are called units. Like if we talk for measurement of time, we use the unit as second. For measurement of volume, we use liter. We use measurement of length as meter. Similarly, we use kilogram, etc. There are many different quantities, like force is measured in Newton, work and energy are measured in joule, like that. If we talk about some important characteristics, that's very useful to understand. Important characteristics of a unit. If we talk about important characteristics, there are four important characteristics we'll talk. These must be linked with all the units. If the unit is following these four characteristics, then only it can be used as a universal unit for that physical quantity. Like the first characteristic and the most common is, it should be well defined. That means if we talk about a second, then we must know what do we mean by 1 second. If it is clearly defined, what duration is 1 second? Then only it can be considered as a unit. Similarly, 1 liter, 1 meter, 1 kilogram must be clearly defined. We'll define all such units later. Number two is, it should be easily accessible and reproducible. That's quite obvious, as the statement is clarifying. The unit which is well defined must be easily accessible, that can be measured clearly. Reproducible means any number of times we can use the same unit for the same physical quantity. Another one is, there's also very important, that size of unit must not be too large or too small. Like if we talk about 1 millimeter, that is a very small length of the unit. So meter is fine, milli is a prefix we use for measurement of small units. But if we define millimeter as a standard unit, then it will be very difficult for measurement of large lengths. Similarly, different type of units can be defined for large and small length measurements or any other physical quantity measurement. So whichever unit we choose for our physical quantity, it must be moderate. It must not be too large, must not be too small, so that the measurement becomes very difficult. Fourth, the last and the most important characteristic, the important characteristic of a unit is, it should not change with the time or other physical conditions. Like pressure, temperature, humidity, etc. In any surrounding environment, if some physical conditions are changing or with time, the unit must not change. That means if we talk about meter as a unit, then at every temperature, every pressure, humidity, or always, 1 meter will remain 1 meter, it is not going to be changed. Similarly, 1 second duration is defined as 1 second. That's why we call these as a standard magnitude quantities. If any unit is changing with time, that cannot be used as a standard unit for measurements. You must be careful about the basic definition of unit.